Within the past few years, Sacramento has been called the farm-to-fork capital of the world. We see leading wineries producing the best wines from the foothills to Napa and beyond. New restaurants in the region and local chefs are gaining national attention. But long before Sacramento blossomed in food and wine, Daryl Cordy set the stage as a notable international food and wine expert. He's a force in the development and growth of the California wine industry. Daryl is a second-generation Californian from a family that started Sacramento's iconic grocery store, Cordy Brothers, in East Sacramento. Frank and Gino Cordy started the store in 1947. It's a landmark with a focus on customers, food, and wines. Their caring attitude was passed on by Frank to his son Daryl. And more than just a store, they were leaders in education, with a national newsletter containing a wealth of information about food, food products, production, and wines. Foodies love it. And Daryl, with his knowledge and creativity, offers straightforward thoughts, expert opinions, and a focus on quality. Daryl has always been ahead of his time. He was a catalyst in the reevaluation and renaissance of Zinfandel and other wine varieties grown in the Sierra foothills. Those that know food and wine and need help consult with Daryl Cordy. Leading publications like the New York Times and Fortune magazine seek Daryl's thoughts, opinions, and quotes. He has been a contributing editor of Sevre magazine. Daryl is also involved in tasting panels for regional, state, national, and foreign wine competitions, and is a member of several wine and food societies, notably the American Society of Enologists and Medical Friends of Wine. For his success and expertise, he was made a Cavalier, the Italian equivalent of knighthood, by the Italian government for his efforts in promoting Italian products. It was mostly Daryl who introduced Aceto Balsamico Tradizionale to America. When it comes to olive oil, no one knows more than Daryl. Daryl has received many honors. He has earned the Bacco d'Oro Award by the Italian Government Institute of Foreign Trade in recognition for his work promoting quality Italian wines. He's in the Who's Who of Cooking, honoring leaders of America's culinary industry and awards from the American Institute of Wine and Food. And if that's not enough, the Culinary Institute of America Vintners inducted him into its Hall of Fame in 2008. Daryl might simply call himself a grocer, but we all know him as a legend, inspiring the best chefs in the world, bringing new food products to Sacramento, and providing his expertise to anyone who asks. He's a star. Thank you, Mr. Cordy.
As a grocer, the owner of Cordy Brothers in Sacramento, and he is. And when you ask him, he'll tell you that he's a grocer. But around the country and the world, he is a leading food and wine expert. He has the respect of a lot of chefs around the world, and he has consulted on food and wine and other alcohol on dignitaries and even U.S. presidents, to psyche festivals, to taste tea somewhere in China, and of course a lot in Italy and my home country, Greece. And he has, at the same time that he has advanced a lot of great stuff that we have here in the valley, he has brought to us a lot of great tastes and flavors, not only Sacramento, but California and the United States. In fact, even long before we decided to be the farm-to-fork capital, he's the one that knew what our region has and to advance, to celebrate that. They talked about Zinfandel. Yes, he's the one who is instrumental in the renaissance of Zinfandel, especially in this less than 14% alcohol. He grew in Sacramento, and he went to Bishop Armstrong High School, he told me last night, where he graduated in this room 59 years ago. Is that right? Before he moved a few miles from here to St. Mary's. He has received a lot of awards, and he has been featured in a lot of national and international publications. But for me, I mean, there are a few things, small stories that different people have told me that it is so important and show who he is. Alice Waters from Sepanese, they asked him, what does he do when she does not know something about food? I said, of course, I call Darren Corey. A few years ago, I met a gentleman. He's one of the major leading importers of French wines in the United States today. He's a Frenchman. His first job was sometime in the 70s for the Antinori family in Italy. And the first year that they decided, of course, I understand from Rick that the store used to carry the Antinori wine since the late 60s, but sometime in the 70s, the first year that they decided to really attack the US market, 95% of the exports the first year went somewhere in Sacramento to Gorey Brothers. Because there are a lot of other fairs, like I understand Rick, correct me here, he was the first one who introduced the white truffles in the United States. He's the first one that brought the real balsamic vinegar in the United States. Now, talking about Greece, of course, he made a deal a few years ago with a brewer over there, and he exported hops that they made a beer that they brought it here, and now we need to do a little more of that. But in addition to that, he knows all 72 varieties of Greek grapes and wines. I mean, he's, you know, I don't think any Greek knows that. Oh yeah, he knows how to speak Greek, and of course, you know, his license plate is Enos, Greek for wine. Anyway, I mean, even though he's a eater, he's here to help every customer when you go there with recommendations and thoughts and many times very, very strong advice. He's humble, he's personable, and I believe that he represents the heart of Sacramento better than anybody else. And he's really shown in the world that will be never forget. And ladies and gentlemen, it's my honor to present to you my friend, Professor Darren Corey.
There you are. Being on the Walk of Stars is a true honor. I really do not know if it's deserved or not, but there you are. I would like to recognize some people regarding this honor. First, Frank and Gino, my father and uncle. The brothers Corey. If it were not for them in 1947, I would not be standing here tonight. Second, my employees. If it were not for them, there would not be the Corey Brothers. After all, an army is as good, is only as good as its soldiers, and they have soldiered on, keeping things going, and are the true interface with our customers. Thank you all. Third, the people of Sacramento who are our customers, sometimes now into four generations. Without you, there would be no Corey Brothers. Thank you. And lastly, thank you to the sponsors and crew responsible for putting all of this on. I know how difficult it is. It's almost like herding cats. Kyrie Sotiri, Karistopoli. Sacramento has to stop hiding its light under a bushel. We have many things to be proud of, and we have to make them better known. When you see friends who are from far away, you should always say to them, come, visit Sacramento. My thanks for honoring, through me, my company, my employees, and our customers. Thank you.